In the last lecture, we have discussed about the discrete time Fourier series and how to compute the coefficient of discrete time Fourier series. This time, let us discuss some of the properties of discrete time Fourier series. So, linearity let us discuss linearity. This says that if we have got two discrete time periodic signal xn and yn and its discrete Fourier coefficient is ak and bk. Now, if we construct another periodic signal using these two, say zn as axn plus byn, then we have to find out what is Fourier series coefficient. What is Fourier series coefficient? Let us say the Fourier series coefficient of this is ck, or let us try to find out the Fourier series coefficient of this. Now, before doing this, let us write two equations which we will be doing very often and all. Say first Fourier series for this, say xn summation ak summation over n for one period e raised power j k omega naught n and ak 1 by n summation over, this is summation over k, summation over n x of n e raised to power minus j k omega naught n. These are the two equations which if we use judicially we can prove most of the property. So, let us say that this is Fourier series coefficient is ck. This Fourier series coefficient is ck. Then from this relation ck will be given by 1 by n summation over n a of x n plus b of y n e raised to power minus j k omega naught n. Now, let us break this into two summation. 1 by n summation a x of n e raised to power minus j k omega naught n plus 1 by n summation over n b y n e raised to power minus j k omega naught n. Now, since a and b are any two arbitrary constants, I can take and be out and we can write as ck equal to a 1 by n summation over n x n e raised to power minus j k omega naught n plus 1 by say b b 1 by n summation over n y of n e raised power minus j k omega naught n. Now, if I use this equation, then we get Ck as AAk, and we can write a similar equation for Vk here, and that will turn out to be this. This will be BBk. So Ck will turn out to be a linear combination of the Fourier coefficients of these two periodic signals, which will be Ak plus Bk, same linear combination, same constant A and B, they appear here also. This is linearity. Then we have time shifting. Time shifting property of Fourier series. This says that if we have got a periodic signal xn and whose Fourier coefficient is Ak, then what is the Fourier coefficient of a shifted signal? What is Fourier series coefficient? This we have to determine. Let us use this equation. That means xn is k summation of a k a k e raised power j k omega naught n. Now replace n by n minus n naught in both sides. That will give x n minus n naught summation over k a k e raise power j k omega naught n minus n naught. This can be rewritten as summation over k a k e raise power minus j k omega naught n naught and into e raise power j k omega naught n. If I compare these two series, this series with this series, they are the same. So rest is the Fourier series coefficient of this. So Fourier series coefficient of x n minus n naught turns out to be a k e raise power minus j k omega naught n. That means there is a phase shift in the Fourier series coefficient of x n. If Fourier series coefficient of x n is a k, then the Fourier series coefficient of x n minus n naught will be a k into e raise power j k omega naught n. That means there is a variation in the phase of a k, magnitude remains the same. Frequency shifting. This property says that if the Fourier coefficient of x n is a k, if Ak is the Fourier series coefficient of a periodic signal xn, then what would be the Fourier series coefficient of the signal jm omega naught n xn? we can prove it very easily if we start from here. Ak 1 by n summation over n, then x of n e raised to the power minus j k omega naught n. Now instead of x n we must have e raised to the power j omega naught n. So let us replace k by k minus m in both the sides. Then this becomes a k minus m as 1 by n summation over n x of n e raised to the power minus j k minus m omega naught n. Now we can rewrite it as x n. Let us retain from here e raised to the power j k omega naught n like this. Then the other term this means the Fourier series coefficient of this signal is a minus k, and that is required. Next is the conjugation property. Conjugation. This says if the Fourier series coefficient of a periodic signal xn is ak, then what would be the Fourier series coefficient of a signal which is conjugate of xn? This we have to determine. To do this, let us take this series xn. Here is summation over k for on any period ak e raised for jk omega naught n. Now I want the Fourier series coefficient of the conjugate of signal xn. So let's take complex conjugate of both sides. Take complex conjugate of both the sides, then this becomes whole complex. Let's simplify this. So this will become summation over k, then ak complex and e raised to the power minus jk omega naught n. Now if I compare these two, this is plus and this is minus. So till this becomes e raised to power j k omega naught n, we cannot say that this is Fourier coefficient. So to get a plus term, let us replace k by minus k. Replace here, replace k by minus k to obtain summation over k या माइनस के कॉम्प्लेक्स इज फॉर जे के ओमेगा नॉट एन. नाउ इफ आई कंपेयर दिस विद दिस, आई कैन से द फोरियर सीरीज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ दिस सिग्नल इज दैट ऑफ दिस. दिस इज कंजुगेशन प्रॉपर्टी. देन time reversal, time reversal this says the Fourier coefficient if x n is a periodic signal with a period n, its Fourier series coefficient is ak, then what is the Fourier series coefficient of xr minus 1? That means a signal which is a time reversal of this. To do this, let us again start from this. I have this as the starting point. Then you know that xn is summation over k ak e raised power j k omega naught n. Now if I replace n by minus n, I will get this. So replace n by minus n in both the sides. So this becomes x of minus n summation over k for a period, for one period, ak e raised to minus j k omega naught n. Now if I compare these two, this is positive, this is negative, so this has to be positive, then only you can find this Fourier series coefficient. So this we can achieve again if we replace k by minus k. So replace k by minus k in both the sides. We do that, then we get x of minus n summation over k for one period, on any one period, a of minus k e raised for j k omega naught n. Now if we compare this, I can say that a of minus k is the Fourier coefficient of x of minus 1. Now having done this, let us examine one case. If xn is a periodic signal, xn is a periodic signal, periodic real and even signal.